Hey folks, it's Frithgar. Hey, how you doing? Welcome back to old times. Just gather up these coins again. I am curious what's going to... I already gathered some eggs, by the way. I am curious what's going to happen when I reach 100 coins and there's still coins all over the place on the floor of the map. We'll worry about that when the time comes. Hopefully it doesn't make it all crash. Right, I've gathered a load of bales. I didn't gather all the bales. There are still more bales to gather. And the fertilizer spreading has finished. We've got this one here. I think I would like to get a pressure washer mod at some point. I do actually have a pressure washer mod, which kind of fits with an old style of pressure washer, even though the skin does look a little bit newer. I think it'll be okay. I think it's excusable having the slightly newer skin on it. It's a portable one, which I think is actually really good. But it's quite expensive, so we can't afford it now, so we don't need to worry about it. So I'm going to park this one here, or at least put the fertilizer spinner here. Let's lower that one down. Unhitch. Right, there we go. And we're going to head off the shop. I've already bought this... I've already bought a plough. It's only a meter wide, okay? It's a two-furrow plough. It only ploughs 1 meter at a time, so... It might take quite a while to plough our fields with it. However, our weekly question while we're driving over there is this here is a Pika Model 75. It is the first ever fully automated mechanical tree cutting machine that would delimb the trees and cut the trees to a specified length. It was first manufactured and sold in 1975. Do you want me to use it in this map? Now, I can't actually use that one because we don't have a mod that represents that is that one. But what I have found is this one. This one right here. This, I believe, the Wood Harvester PL19B3. It does have the Ponzi header on it because that's the only one that we've got available in the game. But I think it does closely resemble the actual Pika Model 75. So if you're happy for me to use this, because it is pre-1980, if you're happy for me to use this, then head down the comment section below, let me know yes or no. It's your vote, it's your game. Now, let's get this little plow. This thing is tiny. This is absolutely tiny. So yeah, if we do get that, it'll be something that I hire rather than buy, because it's hideously expensive. And I'm not quite sure when it'll be, but we'll worry about that when the time comes. This is going to take a while, so what we will end up doing is we will put the hired help doing this ploughing. We're going to do a few strips across the top first, but once the hired help gets going with the ploughing, then we can go on and do a few other things. The combine is finished. We've got... Actually, there is just a little tiny bit left with the combine, so we will... There's just like one little tiny bit that is missed in the corner that we've got to pick up. We can empty it out, bring the grain back, empty that out, park up the trailers, and then we've got a few bales left in the other field that we want to gather up. So I'm going to come out of cab for this so that we can start it, and let me just see. We need to, I'm assuming that we can turn it. There we go. Right, we do not want to allow create fields. That is not something that's going to happen. And yes, this is a reversible plow, and yes, back in the days of these types of tractors and plows, it was actually uncommon to get a reversible plow, but that is something that we will live with. So let me, hang on, V to lower it. I don't think, no, there is no unfold option, it's literally just like this. So if I drive along with that in the middle, it is sort of... Yeah, it's doing all right. It's a bit wider than the plough is. Allow create field. No, this is literally the only option that we've got for it. If I come right out to the end... What I'm thinking of doing is... If I lift that... And our mod is working quite well for the soil and the way that that works... So now the tractor will actually lean into the soil. That's brilliant. We want to rotate the plough. It's got to rotate that way. Now, hopefully, it will go the right direction. So lower that down. Hopefully, it should plough all of it. It seems to be getting it. I'm actually straddling it completely. I should be in the row. This plough is actually, it should be a little bit more offset so that the wheel could go in the row a bit more, I think. That'll be all right, like that. That's excellent. Right, let's bring that one out. And we'll try and look at it from a slightly different angle this time. I want to get two or three lengths across the headland here, and then we'll do the same down the other way. Look at that. Oh, that is sensational. That is brilliant. Let's back up a bit. Lower that one down. There. That is... This mod is absolutely brilliant. It's the soil thing. It is listed down below. I do put it in the description of all the videos. That is sensational. Look at that. It's properly in the ground while it's plat. That's brilliant. I love it. Okay, I'm really impressed with that. I've not really looked at it this close up before, and with these small tractors, it really does actually make quite a difference to it. Okay, let's pick that out. Turn the plough. I'm not going to do this entire thing on camera, but I will do a little bit more. We'll do a few more across the top here, and then I can do a few along... I'll do a few along the bottom end down there. And then I can leave the hired help to sort of carry on with it. So let's lower that down. Let's try it from in cab off. This is brilliant. It's properly leaning over as it should when you plough. And if I run the middle down there, that seems to be ploughing okay. I don't know how much space we're going to need to turn, actually. So I don't know how far down the field I need to go before I've ploughed enough. Oops. Too far. I don't want to plough up the track. Right, I'll do once more across the top, and we'll see if that is enough to finish it. Oh, I need to rotate the plough, don't forget that. There we go. Lower it down. Just make sure that I'm lined up correctly. There we go, look at the wheel in the rut. That is brilliant. The thing with this game is it's got so much that you can do with it, and it only takes just the tiniest little detail sometimes on a mod that really just changes the whole way that you look at the game. I mean, it's not much really, is it? Just that little bit where you're dipping down into the ground, but it makes such a difference to the realism of the game and how it plays out for you. It really does. It does for me. I don't know about everybody else. I'm not going to pretend to speak for everybody, but for me personally, it makes a huge difference. Now, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to plough the bottom end of this field, and we will just do one strip across here, I think, because we've got a longer line that we can plough. So if I plough along the bottom, I'll do basically the same as I've done up the top end. We'll run along here, and then I'll do a few more lengths back and forth. It's not actually ploughing very far. I could probably do a bit more than that. It'll be all right. And then we can leave the hired help to continue ploughing this field. And then we've got other things to go and do, like just pick up the combine and collect a few things. That sort of stuff. So I think am I coming out a little bit too far? No, it's all right. That's fine. There we go. Right, so I'm going to carry on with this, and when I've ploughed enough up through here, I'll get back to you as the hired help takes over. Well, I've actually been letting the hired help do it just as I could see how he gets on with it. And I've encountered a slight issue. Because he doesn't drop down perfectly straight each time, he seems to be slowly creeping further and further into the field, which, I gotta be honest, isn't all that helpful. So yeah, we might actually have to go for a slightly bigger plough if we're going to be able to do this properly, which is a little bit of a nuisance. I mean, we can live with it, it's something that we can work with, but it is slightly frustrating because I bought that plough. Now, we do have at the moment available to us the lizard plough, which is from the 2011, I think. That's a 2.8 working with. Okay, it's much bigger than this one. I feel that this one isn't quite so good, and I don't like to use lizard unless I've absolutely got to. So for now, I'm going to use the Lemkin, and I'm just going to sort of live with this horrible hired help issue that it seems to have developed, and I'm going to just start it working on this field here. I think it might actually encounter a bit of an issue when we try to turn around just up there, but we'll see how it gets on. Like right here, look, it's, yeah, it needs to just come out ever so slightly further, like that. We'll try that. There we go. Right, now that is at least ploughing into the very edge of the field. Might have a bit of an issue up there. It's going to go into the bushes a little bit, I think, but again, we could probably live with that. So, yes, I think in the next episode, I will find a different plough. I don't want to use Lizard unless I absolutely have to. So we will start off using this small one, and we'll sort of take it from there. So let me just move over here. He is going to go into the bushes on this little bit, just a bit. He's not actually going to do it too much, but I do apologise for him driving into the bushes. Yeah. Right, so that is my task before the next episode, is to find a plough that is going to be a little bit wider so that he doesn't, because I think he's going to come up and he's going to stop there and he's going to try and turn around. And basically we're going to have patches of this field unploughed. But in the meantime, I've got a combine to go and collect and empty, and we've got some trailers to collect and empty, and a few other little odd jobs that we need to do. And then we've got bales to collect, and then hopefully sheep to buy. I've just got that little bit left there, so I'll just gather that bit a minute. Let's start the combine up. Once this is done, that is actually all of our combining done for a little while. We've got the field of maize that is growing, and that will soon be grown. Probably, well, by tomorrow, that'll actually be grown, and the potatoes and sugar beet will be ready as well. So we do have those that we can get on with at some point soon. I'm going to come out of cab. I wonder if I can get it all into one trailer. Let's have a look. So I've actually got a couple of really good mods for harvesting the sugar beet and harvesting the potatoes. Well, there's one mod, actually. It's a mod pack, which I think is absolutely fan-shmabulous. It is brilliant. And I hope you guys think the same when I start using it. So we will be doing that fairly soon. The ploughing and cultivating, obviously, they're jobs that we can just leave going. We don't need to worry about... what have we got left? 1900. We don't need to stay with them all the time, or that's just going to get really, really dull. I'm hoping soon it will also get a great demand, because then we'll be able to actually start buying a few things. We've got the bales left. We've got this straw in the field here. And I'm considering doing something different rather than baling this. So I might actually row some of this up. I think we might... we got time? I think we've got time to do a little bit of rowing up. I'm going to put this combine away. Well, I'm not quite sure where we're going to store it. So our sugar beet store is over there, but we don't really have a shed big enough to keep a combine in. Now let me drive over to the farm a minute and see if we've got anywhere that we can keep this thing. Because all the sheds we've got are actually quite small sheds, and you can't squeeze the larger machines into them. You certainly can't... yeah. That's about the biggest one that we've got, and this one definitely isn't going to fit in there. Didn't use the mirrors very well on this. Not that you would have ever actually had mirrors. You would have stood up. When you were driving something like this, you would have just stood up so that you could see behind you. So, let's come out of cab a minute, and where are we going to put this one? We've got some barns there, but we're not going to, again, I don't think we can get into them. So let me drive in here, and I did put it into one of those garages there, didn't I? I put it next to the car, didn't I? I put the, when I put it in overnight. Oh, I've still got grain in there. All right, bring the tractor and trailer back, and we'll empty out this grain, and then we'll concern ourselves of where we're going to store the combine. Right, I've left the header out here because I can't actually fit that into any of the sheds, and then the combine without the header will just fit into that shed there, so that's perfect. So that one can stay under cover, and we'll just have to imagine that we have put a tarpaulin over that one to protect it from the elements. The tractor and the two trailers, they are out here. The trailers can just sit there. I think they'll be fine outside. And we'll use the tractor at some point. That will be used for another job. But for now, we want to get onto the bureau and go and do a little bit more bale gathering. So I will finish up this episode, I think, with just getting another load of bales. The plough is going. I have been back and I've checked on the plough. He's doing all right, but it's going to take a very, very long time, and he is, you know, leaving little bits. I'm not happy with it. So we are going to need a bigger plough, and I really don't want to use anything that is lizard unless I've absolutely got to. So like this bale trailer, this is a lizard bale trailer. We don't really have much choice in the matter, so we are going to just have to use it. But I'm hoping that I can get a decent ploughing, modded plough. There's got to be loads of ploughs around, so I will look for one for next episode. This is actually pretty easy, doing this from in-cab. You don't actually see a huge amount, but it does seem to gather them up okay. I was wondering previously if it would actually gather them fast enough, if it could pick them off the ground fast enough. But it seems to, just. You do sometimes have to stop if the bales on the ground are a little bit more numerous than you had previously hoped. But overall, I think it does fairly well. So we've got... I'm not going to worry about the little tail ends of straw that are left here and there. We'll gather up the last of those. There's that, or the last of that line. And like I said, I'm going to try something different. I've got another mod that I found that I'm hoping one of the tractors that we've already got will be able to pull. I won't be able to buy the mod. I definitely know that I can't do that because it's about £12,000. So it's something that I would like, or 12,000 euros, I should say. And oh, by the way, I can't remember who it was that said it, but someone pointed out that this map is actually based off of an area in Germany. So we are in euros, we're not in pounds. And yeah, it's 12,500 euros for this mod that I'm going to be using. You probably guess what it is, but I'm not going to tell you until I'm actually using it, because I'm like that. So yeah, tomorrow we will try out that mod. We'll also try out a plough. So we got quite a lot that we want to do tomorrow, whether or not we've actually got time to complete it all. How many more bales have I got? There's two more going up in. I need one more. There it is. Right, that's the last bale. I'm going to take this back to the yard. Whoops. That's what happens if you go backwards when it reaches the top. It actually flies off the front. It's not a good thing. Okay, I'll take this back and unload it. And then we can quickly hitch in the farmer all... the agromet? I can't remember the name of it now. We will hitch that one in anyway. And we will... start doing some rowing up the straw. Yeah, we need to finish rowing up the straw, don't we? Well, that one's backed in there. Just open up the gates. It's really good, actually, that this fits in here, so we don't actually have to manually push all of the bales in. Just shut the gates on the back of the machine. Perfect. Right, this one really won't store undercover anywhere. We're going to use it again, because I've still got more bales I need to go and pick up. So I'm going to go and find somewhere to drop this a second. And then we can hitch into the rake just in there. Actually, I'm just going to put this one right here, actually, just in front of the sugar beet and potato storage. I'm not going to be using the sugar beet and potato storage, incidentally. I've had previous experience with sugar beet and potatoes, and this map doesn't have any way of... using an elevator or anything like that to get them out of there. So sugar beet and potatoes, we will be selling them directly to wherever will give us the best price, and we will do that every time. We are not going to be storing them in there, so that we've got to load them all up by hand. That's just going to take forever and a year. Right, I want to set this one to windrower mode, so like that, and come around to the front. Use the wheel, lower that one down. Perfect. Now, if I get onto the tractor and start this one up, I'm just going to... This one I do out of the cab. It's a bit difficult to try and do this from sitting on the tractor looking at it. It's a lot more difficult, actually. Right, put that on there. Now, that's going to go that way, so... Actually, I'm just going to spin round. It's a lot easier if I do the outside round first. Just do the very outside, and then I'll start doing the land work. Not like that. Hopefully I can sort of scrape in most of the straw. Push it all in. There we go. I'll have to come out a little bit to gather that bit. I'll probably move up and down that a few times. So, if you've enjoyed watching this episode today, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to watch as well. The weekly question, don't worry, I haven't forgotten that. I've just sort of gotten it a little bit ahead of myself. The weekly question, the Pika Model 75, this one right here. If you think that I should be allowed to use something that represents that on this map, which is, and I will show you again, here we go, into forestry equipment. Right, that is there, the closest that I can find to a Pika Model 75, which was actually first manufactured in 1975. If you're happy for me to use this, and, you know, so we can sort of say that that represents the model, the Pika, then please say yes down below. If you would rather I didn't, then say no. It's your vote, it's your game. So, until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar, goodbye, and see you later.